Did you hear about dirty pipe? You better should look into that or watch this video, since that one is quite a huge mess when it comes to your Linux workstations and servers. Let's get into it. Hi, this is Carsten with OpenTech, and while you are here, don't forget to like, to subscribe and to hit the notification bell, since it helps. And now let's talk about dirty pipeline, where it comes from, what it means, and how you can prevent from it. Let's get into it. Back in 2021, engineer Max Kellermann from IONOS, a German web hosting provider, found out that there is a vulnerability within Linux systems running kernels 5.8 and newer, and that vulnerability allowed attackers, or could allow attackers, to ultimately override and alter each and every file on a Linux system, even write protected and immutable ones, and also including system files. In fact, there's already an exploit out there, so that vulnerability is currently in exploitation, and you should make sure that you could update. The root cause, according to Max Kellermann, was that with Linux 5.8, bugs or features have been introduced that would allow the system's page cache to be attacked or overwritten by malicious statements. And to make things worse, the page cache is used pretty much everywhere within a Linux system, even allowing access to write protected and immutable files. And as I already pointed out, there's already an exploit out there, which is addressing the passwords that tie off the system and creates a new root user password, which is obviously known to the attacker and would allow that attacker to gain full control on such a compromised system. Good news is, Max Kellermann also found out how to mitigate from that. Those mitigations have already been incorporated within the most recent versions of the Linux kernel. Well, then we are safe then, aren't we? Unfortunately, it's not that easy. Yes, there are newer versions of the Linux kernel available, but depending on your distribution and depending on the channel of your distribution you are working in, it could still last a while. The Linux kernel versions that already include those patches are, and allow me to read them out since I cannot remember those numbers, are Linux kernels 5.16.11 or newer, Linux kernel 5.15.25 or newer, or Linux kernel 5.10.102 or newer. So if you happen to be on a distribution already providing you these, roll them out as soon as possible. If for whatever reason your distribution is not already providing you those newer versions, you are probably a bit out of control and out of luck. If you, for example, are running Red Hat Enterprise Linux, the commercial Linux offered by Red Hat, which is in the market with claims stating that they are more secure and more advanced than others, you get to feel tough reality. There is no update yet. But it also applies to other distributions. For example, in the Debian Bullseye stable branch, the update has not been incorporated. If you have access to a Linux providing you different streams, different versions, different branches, whatever you might call them, you could be in luck though. As for example, we found out that the security or the SID branches of Debian Bullseye already contain the patched kernels, and you could simply use those kernels on your stable version of Debian Bullseye. So to summarize, what can you do to prevent from being exploited? Well, first thing is a very general thing. Lower the attack surface, meaning your Linux should not expose an SSH port to the outside world if you can prevent that from happening. You should always have your servers in some sort of a special zone where you can only access them using VPN or other means of secure communications, and then and only then use SSH. Secondly, if available, update as soon as possible so you get those new versions of the Linux kernel being rolled out. Thirdly, if there is no update available, check the other branches of your Linux distribution if there is something available and at your disposal. And if that is not working, probably fourth, compile your own kernel. So you would make sure that you have the latest kernel version available for your distribution. So again, a lot of effort to be invested into that, but ultimately it is worth it. So what do you make out of that? Did you already roll out a new kernel version? Or is your distribution not providing you with any updates yet? Let me know in the comments below. And while you're there, don't forget to like, to subscribe, and to hit the notification bell, since it helps. Thanks for watching, see you next time, and don't forget, let's make the world a better place, now more than ever. Thanks for dropping by, see you later. Bye.